Hi, I'm Jean from Dongfeng Air. A couple of days ago, I was at the Paris Air Show, a large international aerospace event taking place 30 minutes away from the city center. I had the incredible opportunity to interview two Chinese commercial launch companies, CaSpace and Galactic Energy. If you're new to the Chinese space sector, you may want to check out my 2023 review of the Chinese commercial launch landscape. And otherwise, here's a two-part series of interviews, starting with Galactic Energy.
Well, Claire, thank you so much for accepting this interview with Dongfeng Hour. Maybe to get started, can you introduce yourself?
谢谢邀请我接受你们的采访。我是毕业于中国的中国传媒大学，主修的是国际传播和英语。然后我加入星河动力差不多是在2019年的时候，当时是作为公关总监，然后负责星河动力的品牌和公关传播。
Okay, fantastic. And I've been to the Paris Air Show many times. This is the first time that I see this many commercial Chinese companies, space companies.Is this the first time that Galactic Energy is joining the Paris Air Show?
对，我们是第一次参加巴黎航展。我们是想作为一个中国民营企业的代表来去，把我们中国的民营商业航天去作为一个展示的出口，把巴黎航展作为我们展示的出口，让我们中国的民营商业航天能够登上国际的舞台。对。
Okay, so.Let's discuss a little bit Galactic Energy's rockets. So far you have one rocket in service, the Ceres-1, solid fueled, and it's had an impressive success rate. I think 100%, 5 launches so far. There's one planned really soon. My question is, what are we looking at in terms of the ramp up of launches in 2023 and 2024?
我们在2023年的下半年会进行6到8次发射。然后会包含两次的海射，对，我们在2024年会有一个差不多每年从2023年到2024年，每年差不多会有10到20发的一个发射任务，对。
Okay, that's a very significant wrap up. Maybe one question, because you mentioned sea launch today. What is the objective of launching from the sea as compared to 酒泉？
是为了打不同的轨道的倾角。因为我们的火箭它是快响应的，所以它可以在发射车上发射，也可以在船上发射。对，那其实有客户需要我们打什么样的倾角，或者是打什么样的轨道，我们会根据客户的需求去看我们到底在哪里发射。然后在海上发射也是我们对于中国这个东方航天港的一次首次的使用，对，也是我们的一次尝试。对。
Okay, so 酒泉。Sea launch is maybe in Shandong?
Shandong 的海洋港。
Okay, Haiyang, and I know that in Wenchang, they're building a commercial launch base.
对对对。
And there are two pads for solid fueled rockets. Is that being considered as well for...?
我们会在文昌可能会去举行我们的液体火箭的发射。
Okay.
我们的液体火箭 Pallas-1, 它会在2024年进行发射。那其实地方我们有考虑文昌也有考虑山西太原，对，但是现在还没有完全确定下来在哪里发射。
That's great. And then it's a perfect transition to the Pallas-1 actually. So the Pallas-1, as you mentioned, liquid-filled rocket, significantly higher payload. This is a big step up for Galactic Energy. You mentioned 2024, that's for the maiden launch. Are we talking about the second half or the first half of 2024?
是在下半年，是在2024年的下半年会进行首飞。
Okay. I don't know if you have any information about this. What are the latest developments today with the Pallas-1? How has the development going?
我们现在目前已经完成了我们苍穹50，也就是 Welkin In 这款发动机的全系统试车。我们会目前来讲，我们会一直去试它，直到一个累计的秒数。比如说，我们要突破累计试车10000秒到100000秒，对。然后呢，我们现在目前，液体火箭制成星一号已经，完成了一些组装的测试，因为在我们的那个，安徽池州那边，我们有落地一个液体火箭的厂房，对，我们在那边会进行火箭的组装总装。对，总装测试，目前已经完成了总装测试和主发动机的一些长程试车。
And I actually saw that Galactic Energy released videos of that assembly in Shizhou, so our viewers can see that. I'll share the link in the description. One topic that's very hot in commercial launch is reusability. And if we look at Chinese commercial launch companies so far, let's take Landspace, for example, they seem to be doing it in two steps. You know, Juche 2, first expendable, maybe modifications in the future to be reusable. If we look at Tianping Keji, they have their Tianlong 2. It looks expendable now, but on their website, it looks like a reusable rocket. On the other hand, we have other companies like Deep Blue Aerospace. They use the Xingyun Nebula M to do vertical takeoff, vertical landing, low altitude hops already. My question is, what approach are you looking at with the Pallas 1? Are you hoping to make it reusable at the first launch, second launch, or, you know, much later?
我们首先第一次发射它是不会回收的。 它可能和其他的公司一样都会是一个一次性的火箭，但是我们可能会是带载荷上去，因为回收技术可能它还是一个长期的研究的一个领域。我们目前来讲已经在进行一些火箭回收的一些测试试车，包括这个像 SpaceX 一样的炸猛跳的一个回收。 我们现在已经进行到了50米级的一个程度，
okay.
但是像如果要突破100米级或者是1000米级，我不知道会在什么时候， okay. 但是目前我们也在进行这个回收技术的一些研发当中。
Okay, that's very interesting because when Deep Blue Aerospace, they published those low altitude hops of the Nebula M, that was very exciting for the whole community. Hopefully, maybe one day you'll release the footage of those low altitude hops, that'd be fantastic. So that's good to hear. So a two-step approach, very similar to other Chinese commercial launch companies. One quick question that's not in what I had prepared, but I remember in the animation of the Pallas 1, it lands vertically on some sort of, looks like an oil platform. Is that what is planned today, or are you planning drone ships, maybe like SpaceX?
那是我们长期的一个计划，就是我们在公司的10年计划可能是 能够做到太空旅游，我们20年的计划可能是做到这个小行星的采矿，那其实所有的火箭可能都还是需要由这个智神星1号来完成，所以它的回收能够帮助我们很大程度上去降低我们的成本，所以它在海上回收或者是在一个钻井平台上去回收，这个都是我们以后的一些在我们公司的规划当中，但是是在一个长期的规划当中。
Okay, so we can consider that as work in progress. It won't necessarily be exactly what we see in the video. It can change.
对对对。
Okay, that's great. Let's talk a little bit about the market for commercial launch, okay? It seems to me when we look at the launch market in China, one potential very big customer is going to be this Chinese version of Starlink, this super constellation, maybe 12,000-ish satellites. This could be a huge contract for commercial companies. Do you believe that commercial companies have an opportunity to launch satellites from this constellation?
我们有非常大的机会去争取到星网建设的一个订单，因为我们的智神星1号火箭，也就是可重复使用的，它是可以去很大程度上去降低成本，也就是国家队或者是体制内火箭的一个很好的补充。 因为星网建设它可能是一个很大体量的一个星座，几万颗卫星，类似于 Starlink， 可能也或者更多。那我们现在可以考虑说，比如说我们的火箭智神星1号，它能够打几十颗星，或者是其他的公司，我们一起可以去打几百颗星。那其实，我们是共同去吃下这个市场，去共同拿到国家队的订单。对，我们可能国家队的火箭它也不足以去。
Well, so I remember some people making quick calculations. If you take the number of satellites, 12,000 roughly, you divide that by the payload of the Long March 8, that's, you know, dozens and dozens and dozens of Long March 8s to launch every year. That seems like a lot. And so definitely commercial companies, they can provide a complementary launch capacity, as you've mentioned.
对对对，是这样的，我们还是一个主要是一个补充的作用。
And I think also on your presentation, sometimes we see a heavy version of the Pallas 1 with two side boosters. Is that still also on the roadmap?
它可以，对，它是在我们的一个产品的进程里面，计划里面。这个捆绑动型的火箭，它可以增大我们的运力。 两个加上两个 booster 的话，我们的 LEO 运载能力能够达到14吨。这个是 double 了一下我们现在的一个运力，对。
And yeah, 14 tons, we're getting close to the capacity of a Falcon 9, which is deploying Starlink today. Another maybe a bit tricky question. Today, there are many commercial launch companies in China. I mean, roughly 10, probably even more. Each company is planning at least 2, 3, maybe 4 rockets. That's 30 to 40 different commercial rockets. How do you see the market in the future? Do you think the Chinese launch market can sustain so many rockets, or do you see a strong consolidation in the coming years?
其实在我们看来，现在很多家火箭公司，包括国家队的也好，或者是我们民营商业航天的也好，我们推出不同的产品，其实是能够去满足不同的市场需求。比如说有的公司它可能去研制一些亚轨道的 SUBTO 的一个飞行器，或者是有的公司呢，它像我们一样会把这个固体火箭或者是灵活响应的这款火箭去打得很成功，或者是连续发射成功。也有的公司目前来讲是在研发这个液体火箭啊，可回收的技术。其实因为火箭它还是唯一人类能够往返太空的一个工具，所以说不管是什么样的形式也好，或者是我觉得市场其实是足够大的。因为人类在探索太空这个过程当中也会有更多的这个可能需要或者是需求，那我们能够目前来讲去满足一个小火箭去满足快速的布网和组网，然后我们的大火箭去满足这个大行星座的建设，然后有可能以后我们的图谱上也是在去进行一些比如说亚轨道旅游的一些飞行器的研发，或者是这个对于军方我们也在研究一些，不知道你有之前有没有看到我们发的推送，我们也在研究靶弹。所以这个所有的市场我觉得是看都是根据市场需求来去研制的一些产品，包括我们公司也是，对。
Okay, well, that's good to hear and lots of optimism for the future potential for this market. Beyond the Chinese Starlink, Xinwang, what other opportunities do you see? Which other parts of the launch market do you think are most accessible and largest in size?
在我们看来的话，其实除了Xinwang建设的这个订单以外，我们还可以去争取一些国内商业航天、商业卫星公司的订单，包括像银河航天它也会规划了自己的一些星座，包括我们服务的像长光卫星，包括像这个零重空间这些公司，他们都在规划自己的星座。对，所以说我们除了拿国家队的订单以外，我们还服务于国内的这种商业航天市场，还有包括国外的一些这个微小卫星的发射市场，我们也可以去拓展。对，
really interesting. And so how many launches do you think you would need per year of the Ceres-1 or Pallas-1 to be sustainable, to reach some level of profitability?
我们现在是就古神星一号这款火箭来讲，其实已经形成了我们自己的造血能力和盈利的能力了啊。但是呢，为了去，因为我们的同步拓展的这个智神星一号，它是需要一个长期的研究的一个时间和探索的空间，所以它也需要大量的花费。但其实我们目前来讲，去营收的这一部分，Ceres-1 这一部分的这个资金，能够去 cover 住我们在这方面，就是一些，比如说在公司运营上面的一些费用。但是在Pallas-1 这一款火箭上，我们还是需要去进行更多的社会融资，或者是一些地方政府的支持，能够去支持我们火箭的研发。对。
And I think we've noted that Galactic Energy alongside iSpace and also LandSpace, you're really some of the commercial companies that have raised the highest amounts of funding from investors. So that's very impressive.
对对对。现在我们目前正在融最近一轮的融资，应该是会在最近几个月会 close 掉。
Well, looking forward to that. Moving the discussion away maybe from rockets. Let's look at the launch companies outside of China, specifically the US. We see companies like SpaceX, like Firefly, like Blue Origin, Rocket Lab. They're going beyond the launch market and they're looking at opportunities with lunar missions. Starship is also a lunar lander. Blue Origin also got selected recently. Firefly is doing CLPS. Rocket Lab also has the Photon. Are you exploring in the short term or even medium term some non-launch projects, maybe cargo, maybe space tourism? What are you looking at in the short term?
在中国的发射市场其实有很多不同的公司去研发不同的产品，就像刚刚提到的，有的公司在研究亚轨道飞行器，有的公司在研究液体火箭、固体火箭。我们公司其实目前还是想通过去先进行回收，先把我们的自成星一号的回收技术研发出来，然后呢再通过这个再往更深层次的这个太空进发，同时保障我们的这个太空旅游的这个服务能够提供起来，再去完成我们太空采矿的这样一个梦想或者是计划也好。对，所以我们还是专注在火箭的这个研发上。对。
Great. So launch services first, and then potentially suborbital space tourism and space resources in the future. Okay. Well, thank you very much, Claire, for your time. This is really interesting.
谢谢你。
So a special thanks to Claire and to Galactic Energy for accepting this interview. And don't forget to check out our part two of this two-part series with the interview of the company Caspace coming out in a couple of days. If you enjoy this content, please consider becoming a Patreon supporter at patreon.com/dongfanghour or consider joining our YouTube membership program. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.